amidst, I welcome you. I welcome you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here turning things around. I worship you. I worship you.
Oh, Sunday, our Resurrection Sunday. I'm here to welcome everyone today. We're going to give you beautiful music from the crucifixion up into the resurrection. And it's going to be all about the journey that Christ took. So, in the process, we want to thank Voices of Love, who this is our seventh year being together, I believe, but I don't think it's our seventh Easter program. And of course, St. Timothy for allowing us to use their beautiful Amen. Sanctuary. Amen. Along with Voices of Love, we have some guest soloists, and we have some ministers that are going to be partaking up with different journeys with us. They're going to have different parts in the program, and it'll carry us right through the whole ending. So without further ado, I would like to welcome everyone on this Resurrection Sunday, and sit back and enjoy.
Good afternoon, everyone. You look so beautiful out there. Not just because it's Easter, because you are beautiful, because God made each and every one of us beautiful. If you're sitting next to someone, would you reach out and take their hand? As we come before the Lord, with thanksgiving, with praise, and with honor. For truly he is a way maker. And all of us, you sitting there and we who are up here know just how much he has done for us in the past, in the present, and in the future, because he promises he's a way maker. He's a miracle worker. He's a promise keeper. He's light in the darkness. So may we bow our heads, please. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before your most precious throne of grace and mercy. We thank you, Lord, for meeting us in this place, because your word tells us that you are everywhere we are. So we thank you. But even knowing, Lord, that you are here, we invite you here. We want you to be here with us, Lord, leading and guiding as you do so well. You're the only one who can lead and guide us as you do. Dear Lord God, we ask that you would touch each of our hearts deep down in our spirits, Lord, so that when we leave this place today, all of us will not be the same as when we came. And not only for today, but that we will carry it with us every day, lighting your light, Lord, letting your light shine through us, so others, Lord, who may still be in the darkness, will see your light and be drawn to you, so they will know why we celebrate, why we worship, why we bow down before you and love you, Lord God, with all that is within us. Thank you, dear Heavenly Father. Thank you for all that you are, have always been, and will always be. In the precious name of Jesus, Lord, we pray that you will be pleased with this music that we are singing today, because it's not about us. It's all about you, Lord God. We praise you, dear Lord God, in our song. Thank you, dear Heavenly Father. In Jesus' most blessed and precious name, amen.
It was in the Old Testament. Book of Genesis. Where there was so much chaos and wickedness in the land. And the Lord God told his people, his children, take a lamb, take an animal. Take the blood and put it over the doorpost of your house. And when I come by and when I destroy the wickedness in the land, I won't harm wherever I see the blood. But I'll pass over it.
All right now.
Then as we travel and as we journey into the New Testament, there was another lamb that was born in a virgin called Mary. This lamb we know to be, or we call to be, Jesus. Someone say Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, fully clothed with humanity and fully clothed with divinity, embodied with the blood within him. This New Testament blood has power. And when they hung him high, stretched him wide, and when he hung his head, and when they pierced him in his side,
yes,
that blood didn't just cover a doorpost, but that blood covered everybody. And so we can rejoice and be glad because the blood covers all of us. So the next time someone asks you, how did you make it? You just tell them it was the blood.
Yeah.
If anybody asks you, how did you get through it? You just tell them, I was covered by the blood. It was the blood that covered me. It was the blood that sustained me. It was the blood that wrapped me. It was the blood that sustained me. Every time I need him, I thank God because it was nothing but the blood.
My hope in peace. Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
purifies. The blood of Jesus. 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 Oh, thank you for the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the blood. Thank you. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood of Jesus.
Jesus said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I'll raise it up."
Stone.
And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. Here. For an angel of the Lord spoke to the woman and said, "Fear not. Where the Lord used to lay. Let's review the story one more time. One more time. An angel of the Lord spoke to the woman and said, "Fear not. See the place where the Lord used to lay. My. Remember what he said while he was yet in Galilee? What do you say, sopranos?
and nailed him to the cross. They crucified my Savior and nailed him to the cross. They crucified my Savior and nailed him to the cross. And the Lord, oh, yeah. Joseph begged his body and laid him in the tomb. Said Joseph begged for his body, y'all, and he laid him in the tomb. Roll the stone away. An angel came from heaven and rolled.
How many really love the Lord? Come on, how many really love the Lord? We serve an awesome God, don't we? Yeah. The song just simply says, I love you, Lord.
For waking me up this morning, for letting me see a brand new dawning, though I made plans for this day, death could have come during the night and took me away, Lord. But for this, I love, Lord, I love you. I love you with all of my heart, and I love you with all my soul. Lord, I love you. I really, really, really love you. I love you with all of my heart, and I love you with all my soul.
It could have been me. With no food to eat. It could have been me. With no place to sleep. But it was you, Lord, that showed me my sin.
Yeah.
And then you came along and gave me so much joy deep down within.
Yes, I do.
Said I love you, Lord.
Ooh, oh, oh.
I love you with all my heart.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And with all my soul.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I love you. Yeah, 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 yeah. I love you. I love you.
I love you.
remember the times when I came down to my last dime. You snuck my head on time. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
I remember the time when I was sick and I couldn't get well.
When he delivered me,
it was so
that was marvelous.
Marvelous.
And when he changed my life, it was marvelous. He even set me free.
And he set me free.
It was marvelous.
It was marvelous.
I want to thank you, Lord.
It's
mine.
How many know that he is marvelous? What a mighty God that we serve. Have you been enjoying yourself thus far? Come on, I don't sound like, have you been enjoying yourself thus far? Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise. We're now going to continue in our giving through worship, through our giving tonight. And we want you to be a blessing. You know, when you have worship services as such that you're sitting in, it takes a lot of preparation, a lot of time to rehearse, a lot of time that it takes for the directors and the musicians to get together. But we love what we do because of the glory of God. Well, in anything that we do, it takes finances to run ministry. And so the offering this afternoon is going towards the Voices of Love. And we want to make sure we bless this ministry that has been a blessing to you this afternoon. And so we ask you to prepare as the ushers will come. And we're going to march around. And if the musicians can give us some marching music, some giving music, some free giving music, amen. Liberate us a little bit to give God glory through our giving. We ask you to stand and follow the directions of the ushers. I just want to praise you forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. I just wanna I just wanna forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. Oh, blessings and glory. I know for me. Blessings and glory and honor, they all belong to me. Thank you, Jesus, for blessing me. Amen. We pray that each of you had an opportunity to give. Let us pray. Almighty God, we come to say thank you for giving us the resources to be able to give back unto you. Lord God, bless the giver and bless the gift, that it may go, O Lord, to bless your ministry, that it may be a blessing to someone else through song. Lord, we thank you, O Lord, because you have been so good to all of us, and you have blessed each and every one of us. And we say thank you tonight. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Let us stand, all things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own.
To the church at Ephesus was a prison epistle. Paul tells the church at Ephesus how he wound up in prison. He got there from preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. He tells the church at Ephesus, because it is generally a Gentile church, of the universality of faith in God, that is neither for Jew or for Gentile, for bond or for free, but for any man that would trust in God. But he warns them to not let their afflictions stop them from being bold in the Lord. Paul says that this walk comes with trouble. It comes with challenges. And you must learn to be bold in your affliction. You got to keep learning to keep moving forward when you want to quit. To keep holding on even when you're hurt. Paul encourages their hearts. And then he ends the third chapter of the letter to the Ephesians with what is called a doxology. That's the formal name of it. But what it really is a praise break. Paul literally says, since no matter what the world throws our way, we're gonna keep believing. Since the trouble is going to come and we're gonna stand against the trouble. Since our God is able, we might as well go ahead and praise his name. And now, on the hill. could ask or think. To the all-wise God, according to the power at work in us. Oh, we shout that God has all power. But how many of you know God empowers? According to the power at work in us. Be glory. Anybody want to give him glory? Be glory, dominion, majesty, and power, both now and forever. What Paul says to the Ephesians, and what I stop by to say to you this evening, is that you and I must develop the fortitude to keep on praising God in spite of. Somebody say in spite of. In spite of. We're going to praise his name in spite of. We're going to lift him up in spite of. We're going to shout hallelujah.
Every day you wake up, you are instantly thrust into a conflict into which you must make a definitive decision. There will be voices, views, and various vantage points vying for your attention. The network and cable news, first of all, will assault you with fears in order to convince you into believing that politics and government have ultimate power over your future. Also, people around you, people on your jobs, and people in your circles will pound and pummel you with their doubts, their anxieties, and their pessimisms that life is ultimately one big disappointment, and therefore there is no reason for you to have great expectations in anything or anyone. Then there is the lure of money, which will make its case that without a significant amount of money, then you have no true meaning, value, or worth. And then there are your own negative experiences, which will creep into your thoughts in order to torment you with the troubles of the past, in order to put out the pilot light of hope, whose flame seems to be no more than a flicker at times. But there is also one other voice. This voice will never yell, this voice will never shout, and this voice will never scream its intentions at you, for it is a still small voice. This voice will never try to exploit you through fear. It will never try to manipulate you with money, and it will never try to confuse you with contradictions. But this voice will speak the language of a love that promises it will never let you go and it will never leave you. This voice will speak tenderly about a love that mortgaged two worlds on your behalf, one dark Friday on an old rugged cross 2,000 years ago. This voice will speak passionately about a love that will look beyond your faults in order to love you into your future. And the question that must be answered before your feet touch the ground of your being for this day and every day of your life is, whose report will you believe? Who will have the final say in your life? And can I close with a clue to which voice you should choose? I would suggest that when you see the blood that cleanses you, the blood that covers you, the blood that sustains you, the blood that saved you, the blood that got you up this morning, and the blood that started you on your way, the blood that will never, ever lose its power, then you will know there is no reason to ever fear the future, No reason to ever be afraid of what the doctors might say. No reason to be frightened about how much money you have or don't have. No reason to fret about who's in the White House, because you know who's in the lighthouse. And no reason to be scared because of what's on the nightly news. Because when you see the blood, all you will want to say is, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.
Thank you. always have a choir song with everybody. And what better one than this one? I have no reason to fear. Some of you all out here right now, you scared. I don't know what you're scared of, but you have no reason to fear. And if you believe that, stand up to your feet, and we want to hear you sing. Uh-huh. The sopranos, go give you your part.
Oh, the blood, I'm covered by the blood.
Oh,
we have certainly been ministered to on tonight. It sounds like in the house that somebody's covered.
All right.
By his blood. That is a testimony to many of us that he brought out of darkness into his marvelous light. But before we leave this sanctuary, this house of prayer, this moment in worship, there may be someone that has not declared that he is Lord. And this day, Resurrection Sunday, is a wonderful time to give your life to the one that died on Friday, but rose on the third day. As we stand all over the sanctuary to encourage someone that may be in our midst, that said that heard the word through song, the Savior that had come to save. He's come to change your life because your life is worth saving. Is there one that would come? Don't worry about what church. We want to make sure that you are in the ark of safety. We'll find a church home for you. If there's none, you may be seated.
You, we're not going to keep you longer. These remarks are going to be really short. Thank you for giving up that, what you got at home, ham, turkey, whatever. Thank you, burgers, whatever you have at home. I thank you. And I bet you God is proud too, because you have sacrificed. And that's what the whole day is about. And sacrifice was made during the time when I was residing in Georgia, and I must recognize these people quickly. And then you see the last song says, "Church, let's rock." You do see that. All right, so we want to have a chance to do that before you go home. But first of all, I praise God for Chris. Yeah, Chris was the slave man. I'm sorry, was the director during the time. I was gone. And then Chris ran into some issues where he wasn't able to be. And we began to wonder about what was getting ready to happen with this bunch of love that you see up here. And I would like, really quickly, if Anita, Tony, and John could come up real quickly. Real quickly. I'll start with John. John was having to do the majority of the rehearsals, and all of these individuals are coming from Illinois. And I thank you, you know, for carrying on. And thank you for carrying on.
Amen.
So these people tonight's alive. And I thank you so much for it. And a public service announcement to those of you who always said, oh, I wanted to join that choir, but you have enough people. It's not the number. Please make no mistake. It is the love. It is the love. These are representatives of over 27 different churches. And I praise God for all of them. For Andrell and Christian and Joe, God bless you. Thank you. Love you. St. Timothy, Pastor Jackson, thank you so much for opening up the doors. And Pastor Dwight Gardner, Pastor John Jackson, and my brother, for real, Reverend Kenneth Gray. And thank you. We love you. Church, let's rock.
I don't know how we voices can express. I don't know how we voices can adequately express how glad, how pleased we are to have you back with us. She said, I'll see you at rehearsal tomorrow. But I do want to say really quickly, Patrice, that I recently heard a preacher teacher say that when we anoint someone with oil, it's just a symbol. It's just a symbol of the Holy Ghost. And I want you to know, Patrice, if you don't know it already, you are so anointed with oil. There is so much Holy Ghost in you. That, honey, when I walk around you, I have to hold on so I won't slip on the oil.
Thank you, ushers and sound people. I forgot.
Thank you. just want to thank you, because you've been so good. You've been mighty, mighty good. You've been real, real good. You've been real, real good. You've been better than good. You've been.
All glory, honor, dominion, and power. In the precious name of Jesus, amen. Bye-bye.